Hey there, everybody, and welcome back. In this tutorial, we are going to look at the new generative AI features within Adobe Photoshop. So let's go ahead and get started on how to use the various generative AI features here in Adobe Photoshop. So the very first one I want to kind of play around with is generative expand. So here you can see we have an image of some headphones and a computer. We're going to kind of scale this out a little bit. Well, let's say we want to expand this to be more of a square image, maybe for Instagram or something to that effect. I'm going to go ahead and navigate to my crop tool, or I'm going to hit C. As soon as I hit C, the Photoshop flyout bar here will say, hey, do you want to do generative expand on this? And I sure do. So I'm going to go ahead and just kind of eyeball a square. I don't need to be exactly correct, but if I wanted to, I could change this to the square setting. And I'm going to go ahead and just hit generative expand, and it's going to ask me what I would like to generate. It does say optional. I'm going to just leave it blank and see what Photoshop comes up with. So it's going to go through the process here, and Photoshop's going to analyze the image and see what it's going to fill this area in with. So let's give it a few seconds there, and as you can see, not too bad. A little bit, you know, it's kind of hard to like match the MacBook brand there, but overall, pretty nicely done. So this image looks really good to me. You can see it created a new layer with a generative fill kind of icon. So it says it's a generative layer. In the properties panel, it gives me more adjustments. So if I wanted to continue to generate variations, I could just simply hit generate or change the prompt. And it also created a mask. So it did this a little bit non-destructively. And so that allows us a little more wiggle room. So in this specific image, I have these nice notebooks, but this is pretty blank over here. So let's go back to our background image and let's select something like our polygon lasso. And I'm going to go ahead and kind of draw a rough shape of what I'd like to think is a notebook. And when you draw a selection and close the selection, we now have generative fill as the option for your menu. So I'm going to type red notebook. And we're going to let that do its Adobe magic, and it's going to determine what type of notebook will be there. Now, these results are not always perfect by any means, but what you want to make sure you're doing, and you can see this looks okay until that area. This looks a little better. This is more what I want. So you will have to kind of play around with your prompts. I'm keeping things pretty basic for this lesson. You can see, again, it is non-destructive. Now, if I were to draw an image up here, for instance, maybe let's hit escape here. Let's go to the elliptical marquee and draw a circle, and let's type coffee cup. And we're going to let that run through. It's all dependent here on layer order. So these masks are starting to kind of cut apart our image a little bit. And so here you look and go, hey, this didn't work. When in fact, if you just drag it to the top, though it's a silly looking cup of coffee, you can see that it did indeed work. And this is the world's tiniest cup of coffee, maybe because I drew the circle a little bit too small. But you can see, though, by default, it doesn't recognize the other layers above it. So you will have to do a little tweaking. All right, let's go to another image and see what we can do. So on this image, maybe we want to add a bit more visual interest in the center of the screen. I'm going to go ahead and we're going to get a... again, elliptical marquee, and we're going to draw a big kind of circle, and then we can kind of move that in place. And we're going to say a plate with lavender on it. So again, using the image, kind of, you know, keeping it within the style of the image that we have, looking really good. Let's see what it comes up with. Now, we didn't specify what type of plate or what, you know, specific type of lavender. So in this case, it kind of read that as a lavender plate. Here's like, I guess, a dessert. This is kind of creepy, but also cool at the same time. So again, if you're not a fan of this, you can just hit regenerate and it's going to give you a few more options. Give that a few seconds to go through. And we're doing this all in real time, just so you can see the, you know, it does take some time to kind of generate. Now that is kind of cool looking. That is a little bit better. I kind of like the first one though. So there you go. So it keeps all of our options. If you don't like an option, you can always rate it here in the scale. And then, you know, another great tool in generative AI is if you want to get rid of elements. So if I want to get rid of, you know, for instance, I'm going to hold shift to add to my selection some of these little kind of flyaway pieces of lavender. If I wasn't a fan of these, I could then go back to my background image, generative fill, and just leave it blank. And that will sometimes remove them, sometimes it replaces them, depending on what type of shape. If you're finding your selection isn't working, it could be because the selection is too close to the object. So this worked pretty good. You can see this one, the rest of them disappeared. If I toggle on and off, this one did not like whatever we were doing. And if that is the case, you know, I can just add a new layer. I'll go above it and we can go to the good old clone stamp tool, which is, again, the clone stamp is S on your keyboard. Hold Alt, and then we can just kind of sample through some of these elements here. And we want to make sure, again, when we're sampling all layers. And if this, again, is masking anything, we can go ahead and hit B for brush. And let's reset our brushes to something a little smoother. There we go. That looks wonderful. And we will paint that back in with white just so we have a lot of area to kind of sample from. And go back to that clone stamp tool and then kind of paint through it. And again, if I put that on the top layer, it looks really, really nice. So again, the old techniques are still very relevant. I'm holding Alt and then I'm releasing Alt and I'm just painting away these areas. So now I have little kind of areas here of clone stamp mixed with this. Now, the final use is kind of a fun one. Let's say we have a vacation picture and we don't like these friends anymore. It's kind of sad. But let's go ahead and go to our polygon lasso tool. And I'm going to just kind of very roughly remove our former friends, right? You know, they're having fun without us. We don't like it. You know, they didn't invite us to jump in the air. So we're going to go ahead and delete this. So again, just like what we did in the last picture, we'll just hit generative fill and hit generate and we'll see what it creates. Give it a few seconds to kind of go through. We could get really complex with generative fill. I'm just showing you the very basics in this video. Through the magic of generative fill, we go away. We also have things like shoes over here. I don't want no stinky shoes in here. I'm going to go ahead and let's see if we can generative fill remove that, getting a few seconds. And then maybe after this is done, if this works well, we'll add something like a sail ship out there. There it goes. Cool. All right. Shoes are away. Go to the background layer, get a big rectangle marquee, and let's type sailboat. We could easily combine these layers. So a good hotkey for that is if I grab everything is Control Shift Alt E. That's a huge hotkey. Control Shift Alt E or Command Option Shift E on a Mac. And we'll just call this flattened. And then we can go ahead and have a nice flattened image to kind of put our sailboat on. Sailboat in water. And a beautiful set of sailboats in the water. So we went from this image to this image in a matter of a few minutes. Again, generative fill is a really fun way to kind of add your own personal touch and creations when you maybe don't have access to go out there into the real world, take photos of sail ships, depending on if you're landlocked or wherever you're from. This is a really great element. And then the final thing I kind of want to show you, and it's not really generative fill, but I'm going to go ahead and flatten that layer again. There is a really cool tool, and we'll actually do this on the one without the ship. Up in the edit menu, it's called sky replacement. And it, you know, it does similar things to generative fill, but essentially what it will do is read your image and kind of determine where the sky is and replace the sky. And it gives you a whole ton of options to kind of put in here and replace. And it even kind of keeps your atmospheric perspective. We could kind of go ahead and add a ton of these images. This one's kind of golden, so it kind of matches. If you want to add your own image, you just go to the add button, and then we could add, if we had a picture of a sky, we could add that in. Absolutely quite amazing, and it's going to do all the grouping for you non-destructively. So again, if you like it or you don't like it, that is edit, sky replacement, awesome tool. There you go, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. I want you to get out there, play with generative fill, see what imaginative compositions you can create, and I'll catch you in the next video.